Hello everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again, and today I'm coming with part 2 of our tutorial how you can make a file folder or a photo folder from envelopes. Last time we did this side, and today we're gonna do this side. And I already prepared all pieces I need, because I would like to show you how you can add these two parts to your journal if you would like to use it like journal, not like just file folder, but like journal. So I already start with this, and I switched on my camera, but then I didn't notice that my camera switched off immediately because that memory was full. And I noticed that when I had already glued this envelope and those two decorative papers. So for this side, for left side, we're gonna need, I'm gonna show you what we're gonna need. We're gonna need two envelopes like this. Two envelopes like this. And three envelopes. This is called C, like Charlie, 5 here in England. And I lost them. Oh my, where they are? Oops. Oh, here. And I already halved these envelopes, but it's this envelope, long DL envelope. This is with window, but I used without window. You can use with window and enjoy that window, somehow incorporate that window to your project, to cut paper around that window, and it will be amazing, beautiful decoration. So we're gonna need, two of these. And four of these envelopes. I already prepared all of them. So what I did, it's take that bigger envelope, like your basic part again. Take one DL envelope, and you can already glue it down. Here I glued that envelope, I think, under this paper. Yeah, I glued that envelope under this paper, but you can glue it, you know, from that back side and glue it down. I decorate inside of my envelope with piece of paper, and I put here another decorative paper. You don't have to put all size of that paper, because here will be those two envelopes. It will be this opening. We're gonna create this one. This is that. This envelope, and here we're gonna create these two flip pockets and these two pockets using two DL envelopes. So if you wanna see step by step how I'm creating, how I'm cutting these papers, it is in part one. Every single steps are in part one. How I am creating this without any other tool than it's my ruler, scissors, and this knife. So now I'm going to continue. I already pre-cut all pieces, and but I will try to explain what I made. And I will try. Yeah, that will be confusing, because my camera confused me now. So I'm going to take those two envelopes, those DL envelopes. I already fold them half, then I created those two envelope flaps. How to make these, it's in that part one as well. So I'm gonna place a link for this part one in the end of this video if you will want to see that, or you can find it on my channel. I already prepared them. I already distressed all edges, and here I've got all papers I will need for my envelopes. So I'm going to show you again. I didn't want to make this one too long, so I prepared those papers, but I didn't, somehow I didn't expect my camera will switch on, switch off. I'm gonna put some decorative papers inside of my envelopes to make it stronger. And decorate it. And I'm gonna leave just small gap. Do not see that inside of my envelope too much. And as you can see, I'm not using full size of paper for my envelope. Like, I mean, I'm not covering with the decorative paper all inside of my envelope, because I think you don't actually need that to cover all inside of that envelope. Because I don't know who will, you know, have a look inside of that. So I'm gonna put all these decorative papers. And I know this tutorial, it's coming a little bit later, but it's because my boys, both of my sons, they had birthday. They are not twins, but they are born at the same day, 1 year between them. So we had celebrating week. And I've been really busy, so I'm coming a little bit late, but I've got already few tutorials, another tutorials loaded to my channel. They will come tomorrow and probably day after. I hope you will like them, because I'm working on few another journals and also on a few embellishments, which I'm gonna use in this journal. This will be not like file folder for Slavka, it will be journal. That's why I'm using a different color than is here, because for small Natalie it will be in this peach color, all that collection. So I've got inside part. Now I can put these pieces for my flips for that envelope. So I'm gonna glue them down. And I'm already starting to prepare another book for Slavka. There is so many amazing tutorials how you can create file folders, photo folders. I'm not using cardstock, I'm using envelopes. It's really not too hard to use envelopes if you will just change, you know, material that which is in those another tutorials. It's really easy to use envelopes, and you don't have to create from cardstock some pockets. You already have pockets if you are using envelopes. I'm gonna put decorative papers on all these flips or lids from my envelopes. I forgot again to have a look. I can't have a look because I actually don't know how to say in my language. It's envelope and it's... See? I actually don't know how to say it in my language. If we have some word for that, I will have to ask my mommy. She was postwoman for a few years. She will definitely know. She knows everything. She's brilliant. Now, I'm going to put decorative papers, they will be inside. I mean, they will be here. So I'm gonna have a look. And I know I forgot something. I forgot to pre-cut these parts, like my another pocket. So I'm gonna cut two labels. You don't have to use labels if you don't have a die-cut machine. You can just cut out some small piece of paper, which will be same size of your papers here. I'm gonna show you what I mean. Choose some decorative paper. Probably I will do it this way, this time. I'm gonna move all this on the side. I'm gonna take one piece of my decorative paper I'm using like a cover for that envelope. This will be like decorative paper here. And if I would like to use another decorative paper like tuck spot here, I need to cut piece which is along like this. So as I'm You don't want to see what was just happened. Oh my. It's when you're working on many projects at the same time. It's falling down. Everything. So I'm gonna take measurement. This is 9.5 centimeters. So I'm gonna make my mark. It was like here. I'm gonna make my mark here. I'm gonna make my mark here. It's 9. I'm gonna take my cutting knife. I'm gonna cut this piece. And then probably I will use just my ruler as a measurement. Because it has 5 centimeters and it's wide enough to use it like tuck spot. So I'm gonna place my ruler on one side of my decorative paper. I'm gonna cut strip, which I will use here like tuck spot. I'm gonna cut another strip, same way. You can measure all this, but I already know that my ruler is 5 centimeters and it's wide enough for tuck spot. So I cut 2 strips. And I think this time I'm gonna use only corner punch to corners. You can use some dyes, some decorative elements, maybe some roses, and decorate this one as well. But if you don't have dyes, you can make just simple tuck spot like this. You don't have scoring board. Take measurement, I think, 1/2 centimeter or how much it is. I think it's just one quarter of inch. Make a marks. I'm gonna use this. This is my, it can be call it like scoring tool. Make a mark. And make score line, small score line. And then use your ruler to help fold your tuck spot to make it nice and even. So we've got one. And I'm gonna make same way on that another piece. It's 1/2 and it's 1/2. Make score line. I think here I move it a little bit. Fold it. Oops. Fold it up. Yep. Fold it up and use, if you don't have scoring tool, you can use a knife, but not with that sharp edge, but with that another edge. I mean kitchen knife, that is the best, probably best tool if you don't have any scoring tool or some, this one, bone folder, that is brilliant for that as well. Fold it. And we've got prepared our tuck spot here, like this. You can decorate it now with maybe with doily. You can place over it a small doily as well to decorate it how you want. Maybe some laces, you know. but I'm going to show you just basic. So I'm not gonna decorate it now. I will decorate it later. Oh, where is my glue? I'm gonna glue it already down. And I'm gonna glue it here on that fold. And also a little bit here. Just a small amount of glue. Make sure you're gonna place it on the right side of your decorative paper you're gonna use on your envelopes. And let it dry. I'm gonna take another one. Put glue here. And also a little bit here. Just a small amount because I want it like tuck spot, not like pockets. Oh, see? Nearly wrong. Oh my. Like this. Like this. Let it dry. Then take your pieces and glue them on your envelope. Glue them down. Like this. Also another piece. And you can place it like this, or by the way, now I am wrong, you can make those tuck spots on both sides like this, but I want just one. So I'm gonna place it on my another envelope like this. Here I want to have just simple those decorative papers, so I'm gonna place them there immediately. And I could my decorative papers, I could 1/4 inch smaller, 1/4. Bear with me, I will have a look on my scoring board, because you know, to work with inches, it's sometimes hard for me. Yes, if this one, where is my 1/4 inch, yes. 1/4 inch smaller than its size of this base. So all pieces, I cut smaller, 1/4 inch. Also for those large pieces, I cut it smaller, 1/4 inch. So measure your envelopes and cut it smaller. I think that 1/4 inch is the best. You've got still a small edge around. Like here, it's small edge around. And it's not too big, but it's not leaving bigger cups, bigger gaps. Now I need this piece. Oh my. And I used again Tim Holtz Walnut Stain Distress Ink. Oh no, no, I wanted to use. I used that Gathered Wings, I think. Yes, Gathered Wings. So we've got inside of our envelopes. I'm gonna glue down also top for these flaps. I'm gonna glue decorated these top flaps as well. And all steps, how I create all these small pieces, I'm showing in that part one. Like this. Oi, not on my hand. Like this. It's one envelope, another envelope. so long time quiet. I'm concentrating to make it right. Do not mess up again. And I'm going to take this large envelope I already prepared. And I'm going to show you how to glue down these to make a pocket here. So here is my base. Here will be that. Here will be this part. So we're gonna glue down these two envelopes. Yeah, come here, these two envelopes. I'm gonna take one. If you are not sure, fold it. And then you need to put glue on these three sides. I'm gonna put their glue. And start to place them from the bottom part of your envelope. Like this. To make sure you will have space for that second envelope. And it will not going down on the... It will not peek out from your book here on the bottom. Again, fold it here. Put your glue here. One, two, and three. And now glue down your second envelope. There will be just teeny weeny small gap. It nice straight. So we've got pockets. We've got pocket here, here. We've got pocket here. We've got pocket here. Also tuck spot, tuck spot. We've got pocket here. Now when we close that, we can decorate this top of our envelopes. I'm gonna use my unfolder to fold it a little bit. And I prepared base papers. Oh, I didn't. I think I cut them wrong. See? Aha. I cut them wrong. I cut my papers same size like this one. Okay, I'm gonna... I'm gonna stop my camera now and I'm gonna cut it again. I will be right back. Okay, I'm back. I cut right pieces now. Exactly 1/4 smaller than it's my base of my envelope. So I'm gonna glue it down. And... No, I'm gonna glue down these bases. Base pieces. Okay. I'm gonna take you... New glue, this is probably nearly empty. So my last glue, I have to go shopping. Everything is going to be last piece. Oops. Oh, when I'm talking about last pieces and shopping, I watched video on my beautiful friend Kay. She's like Kazikins one here on YouTube, and she's making now challenge, her own challenge, like I think it's called declutting your stuff. It's too leak. You know, when you've got new glue, sometimes you need to shake it to make sure that it's not too wet like this one, because this is too wet. It's not tacky. It's not too tacky. Again, it looks better. Yeah, it looks better. So Kay has doing her own challenge. I think she saw that on some another channel. I think it was something like dogs something, poodle dogs, poodle. I don't remember name of that another channel, but Kay, who is Kazikins once, She's doing her declutter challenge. And she's creating from pieces she has a lot. And she's gonna do 100 things. And I think it's a brilliant idea because I've been shopping so much. I've got quite huge stuff here around me, so I have to declutter somehow. But as many of us, I don't like to put it away or something like this. I shared a few things with a local school here. But I like my stuff, so I have to create something. And this challenge is pretty cool because you need to create some simple things, which can be good. Now I've got my smaller pocket, and then I create one more smaller. I used that small piece I got before. So I will have here two pockets on the top. But as I'm gonna use this one for my journal, here I would like to have a little bit different closure than I've got in my file folder for Slavka. Here I've got closure for these envelopes using these tabs. But because I would like to use this space, what we're creating today, for my journal, and that journal will be with laces, I would like to have there a little bit different closure. So I'm gonna use these dies. I make it a little bit stronger, and I made two of them because we'll be here one and another one. So I'm gonna glue this on the side, probably a little bit down, little bit small piece on my, will be in my envelope. Not envelope pocket, not envelope pocket. Like this, probably. And to make sure that another one will be the same position, I'm gonna glue it now. I'm gonna place that another pocket for that second envelope on the top. And I'm gonna glue down this piece as well. It's still wet. I'm gonna shake it a little bit more. So I was thinking I'm gonna do my own challenge to create something. And I was thinking because, you know, Christmas bazaar, it's not too far. I know it's still half a year, but you know, that creating, it's taking time. And this year I would like to go as well. So I think I will start the thing to create some easy peasy something for Craft Bazaar to declutter my stuff. Some good creative way. I will see if I will find some way, if I will find some ideas what to do. I will definitely share it with you. But hopefully I will find some idea. So I've got prepared two pockets with closure. And I will use a ribbon as my closure. So now I'm going to glue it down. I'm going to put glue here as well. I'm going to put glue here on three sides of my pockets. And I'm going to place it on the top like this. I'm going to let it dry. I'm gonna put this second pocket on the top. And same way, I will do that second envelope. So I'm gonna pause my video now because, you know, I would like to show you how you can add that to journal, and it will be, again, so long. So wait, bear with me. I glued that down, so now we're gonna work on this side. I already pre-cut these pieces. One is for inside of my envelope. I'm gonna glue it down. I'm gonna glue it down like this. Make sure that it can be folded. Yes, it can be folded. Good. Then I'm gonna glue it up. This is very easy way. Oops, sorry. is that easy part. This is just covering with decorative paper. So it's very easy. Just make sure, place it right way, not upside down or totally different design you want. And now we're gonna create these pockets. These pockets. And it's very easy, I promise it's very easy. First time I saw that on Katy Orta channel, she had, while ago, she had a very beautiful tutorial how you can make it. What do you need? You need base for your pockets. I cut piece, which is same size like my envelope, just that 1/4 inch smaller. It looks like this. So you need one piece, like your base. And then what do you need? You need to cut pieces. I'm using half an inch folds on both sides, which means I've got piece 1 inch wider than it's my base. And then I'm using for bottom pocket here, I'm using, this is 4 inches deep, 1/2 inch it's scoring line here. So my pocket will be 3.5 inch. And here again, this is 1 inch bigger than its base for my card. When you cut those strips, then you need score lines 1/2 inch on 3 sides, like it's here, because these sides will be fold around our base. And for those others, you don't have to do scoring line here on the bottom. I messed up. Here I don't have any scoring line. You need to make scoring line only on these 2 sides. I'm gonna show you on one piece. So I've got here my cardstock. That this is my base for my pockets. And as you can see, my card is longer than my base. Now what I need is make score lines on these sides, 1/2 inch here and 1/2 inch here. I'm gonna try if it will be okay. It's exactly like this. And then you need to choose which side will be top of your pocket. Here, I wanna have this one like top. So I'm gonna make small score line 1 inch from the top. Just score line. I'm gonna finish my score line with this score line. So I'm gonna show you what I mean. 1 inch. And same, it will be on that other side. 1 inch. It's just, you know, just mark. Hopefully you will see that. It's just mark. And now take your scissors, cut that score line like this and like this. This is top of your pocket, and from that bottom cut in small angle. Hopefully I'm saying that right, in small angle. The first cut, and you've got Katy Orta called these like t-shirts. And I think it's right word. So now you've got fold, which we will fold over our base, and this will be glued down. I'm gonna show you. I'm gonna glue down my pockets. I'm gonna move this one out of our way. Falling down. Oops. I put double-sided tape, small double-sided tape. I think it's a 1/4 inch double-sided tape. Hopefully you see that on the bottom of my pockets, not on that big one, not on this base. I'm gonna start with that base, with that bottom pocket. I'm gonna glue it down. Here I'm going to use just tacky glue. I'm gonna place my card on my pocket, And I'm gonna glue this pocket as a first. And I'm starting with that bottom because these will make like stopper for those another cards. You will know where to stop. Fold it and let it dry if you are using tacky glue. If you are using score, not score, double-sided tape, it's glued immediately. Turn it over and now take off double-sided tape. And I'm using double-sided tape here because I try to use tacky glue, but then I slide my card on that base and it was sometimes it was glued down that pocket in that base because it was there small bits and pieces of my glue. So I'm using here double-sided tape and it's much more easy with good cardstock, it's much more easy to slide it down. Oh, but I want, you know, I want this I'm missing, I think, oh, it's here. I want this, and that. Next one. Am I seeing that right? Aha. Like this. Okay. So this I'm gonna place on the side. First, this one. Because I've got two different decorative papers. And I want them in some kind of... setup. I don't know that word. Place it on right position. Those are like stoppers, so you know where to stop. You can glue down at bottom. You will feel that under your fingers. Turn it over. Fold this over your base card. Use tacky glue and glue it down. Also, other side. Fold it over and let it dry. And another piece. Again, here we've got already take off the double-sided tape. Take it off. Just slide it to your pocket. Stop with these stoppers. Like this. Turn it over. You can already press it down so your double-sided tape will glue down your pocket. Put glue, fold it. It's really very easy and it makes nice and flat pockets. And now I'm gonna take this one with roses. I'm gonna stop because it will be too long. I've got my pockets. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pockets. And now it's totally up to you. You can glue it down straight away, all that piece, or you can make another pocket underneath. It depends where you will put your glue. If you want to have another pocket underneath, maybe it will be good to cover this with some piece of paper to make sure that any tags or photographies which we will put inside will be not stopped by this. And also, because I want to have here, I nearly forget, I want to have here that ribbon closure. So now I'm going to put down my envelopes where they're supposed to be, like this. I will use double-sided tape for gluing down my ribbon. It will be here, another piece will be here, can I take off this double-sided tape, oh maybe, no. I just change my knives and this is too sharp, so it's not too easy. I think I will change my knife.
work with it. It's too sharp. Yeah, with this it's much more easy.
And I'm going to take my ribbon, if I didn't lost it already somewhere. I think I did. Oh no, it's here. I'm gonna have there piece of ribbon and also piece of this fluffy, I forgot name of that. I think piece like this will be okay. One. And another one. Two similar pieces. You know, sometimes my hands are not too crafty. Hey. Here. Similar size. I've got two, one ribbon and one this fluffy, I don't know, I think something fiber something. So I'm gonna fold it half and I'm gonna glue it down this, like my base for my closure. Same way I'm gonna do it underneath on that bottom part, on that bottom pocket, or fold it half like this and glue it down like this. And now I can glue it over it my pockets like this. So I'm gonna use tacky glue. I'm gonna put tacky glue on my pocket. This and now to make right position, I'm gonna glue it down. Yes. Like this. So when I will want to close my pockets, I'm gonna use these small strips. Maybe I should left a little bit longer. Yes, I should left a little bit longer. So I will have to extend that. And I can close it with these ribbons. Like this. And also that other one. You will see why I'm using this one, because I'm making like shabby chic, because that paper, it's beautiful and it's shabby chic. So I'm making shabby chic journal. Hey, where are these ribbons? So close it like this. And these circles, I've got doubled, two layers of these dies, so it's strong, it's beautifully strong. Now we're gonna create that other part, which is our top cover of this file folder. But at this time I'm not gonna glue it down, because I would like to show you how I will add all this to my journal. But I will show you what I made. Here in this top cover we've got magnetic. Here is pocket, large pocket made out of one envelope. It's here. It's magnetic, and when you open it, we've got one pocket, here space for photos, and here another space for photos. So I'm gonna show you what I made, how I put this envelope on this envelope. Here, as you can see, I left this top flip from my envelope. I will need to another envelope, same size. And at this time, I'm not gonna glued this flip inside or somewhere else. I'm gonna this envelope glued on this flip like this. Just make it even. If I will glue it down, I think I can glue it down because then I will cut it anyway. So I'm gonna use tacky glue and I'm gonna put a little bit of tacky glue here. And I'm gonna glue down this envelope. To make it straight and nice. I'm gonna make cover first because that bottom, it's very easy. Here I already pre-cut my piece, which will be put on the top. This is to inside. Yes, this is to inside. So on the cover, we will need to create this closure with this longer flip. So I'm gonna put inside, I'm gonna glue it inside my small decorative piece. It's like this. Make sure that my flap can be, can be glued down. And now what I have to do is cut two pieces. One will be for bottom of my, I'm gonna call that flop. I hope I'm not too far from true. One will be from the bottom of my flop and another one will be on the top. I cut two pieces which are white, same like my decorative paper here, and they are tall, like half of my envelope. It's going to half of my envelope, and I would like to have this beautiful edge here. So I'm gonna show you what I made. It's same way like I did it in that previous video. If you don't have any special die cuts or envelope makers, just take your decorative papers and make sure that you will have that same. Cut your envelope in some angle. And then you just need to a little bit curve those edges. That's it. It's much more easy than to try to somehow matching and counting. This way you've got two similar pieces which can be glued together. And once it will be glued together, you will don't see that you fold it a little bit. So here we prepared base for our flap. I'm gonna distress it and I will show you how I'm putting all together. I'm gonna show you how I create this closure. I've got two circles, they are double layered. It's one bigger piece from 300 cardstock and then smaller piece from this decorative cardstock. I made two of them. And now I'm going to position where I think I would like to have that closure. I think in this position, I'm gonna make mark there. I'm gonna take my ruler just in case I wasn't in the middle to measure this one. I'm gonna have a look and I think I did it just right. Yes, I did it just right. So I'm gonna make hole. And I don't like to have hole through to both pieces. I'm not gonna make hole in this bottom of my flop. I'm gonna make hole just here. And I'm gonna fix my closure just on that top part. Yeah, one more. Oh no, nope. It's done already. Hey, come here. Now I need closure, so I'm gonna use the is beautiful thread or strip. I'm gonna place it here in that hole. Go there. And I'm gonna fix it from that opposite side with a small piece of double-sided tape. Fix it here. Make sure it will not fly out. Now I need to put this eyelet through to my circle and put it through to this hole. And fix it from here. Like this. So we've got closure on that top. I'm gonna glue down this first one probably, and then I'm gonna decorate. No, I'm gonna glue down this first. I'm gonna place it here. Used glue. I hope it's not too confusing. Place glue on my envelope. Am I right? Am I right? Yes, I am. Place glue on my envelope. Place it in the right position from both sides. Fold it. Now I can glue down this one. So I'm gonna put my glue over on all that surface. If you don't have these eyelets and tool for making these type of closures, you can use brads, you can use you can just stitch that closure with some button. So it's that top, like here, and as you can see, it's full cover that bottom of my flop. And now we're gonna create that base for our envelope. I already pre-cut this piece, so I'm gonna place it in position I would like to glue it down. And now I'm going to take my another circle and I'm gonna place it in position I would like to have that circle on my decorative paper. Again, I'm gonna take pen and I'm gonna make mark. I think it's here. Yes, it's here. Make a mark. And the same way, I'm gonna make a hole here. And it's like this. I'm gonna make a hole. I'm gonna take eyelets, put it through to here. Through to that hole. Hey, do not lose it. stay there, and fix it. And if you need so, use some tool to lift it up a little bit to make sure you will have a space for your trim, for your thread, for a ribbon, for anything you're gonna use like closure. You can do similar with that lid. Lift it up a little bit, not too much, not rip your papers, just a little bit. Now I can glue down my paper and we done. I'm just gonna tidy up this space a little bit because it's too many here already. Okay, I'm gonna glue down my paper. This, let it dry. Now I can measure how large piece of ribbon or that thread I want. I think like this, and we've got closure done. That's this part. And what we have to do now, it's this magnetic part. So for that magnetic part, I've got here this piece which will be glued down here like this. This piece which will be glued down here, and I used just scrap from my paper, so it's not till the end, because here I'm gonna use smaller envelope. I showed you in that part one how you can make it from a large envelope. But if you have small envelope, just use it here. I already pre-cut all pieces. So I'm gonna show you. This we can glue down immediately. Like this. Oh, no. It's the back. Before you will glue down this part, you need to know how you want to use it. If for your journals, or if you want to make similar like I've got here. If you're going to have similar like file folder, now you need to do your spine. Now you need to create your spine. Good piece of paper. Or I think you call it that craft text, which is much more stronger than normal paper. It's brilliant for spine. Good, this one. Or you can use those fabric papers, which are much more stronger than normal paper. For spine, you need something what will be strong and what will hold all your papers together, all these layouts together. Here I used this decorative paper, and from bottom part I've got something like that fabric paper, which makes that spine much more stronger. So a good piece, long, similar, like is your envelope, and wide. Here I used 5 centimeters, which is, I'm gonna have a look, it's 2 inches. I cut 2 inches strip, wide strip for this spine. First I glue it here. Before I glue down, this decorative paper, I glue it here and fold it down. Then I glue down my decorative papers and that envelope, and then I decorate it with all that other way. You can glue it down and glue down also your back part. And if you want to use it in journals, I'm going to use just this part in my journal. This one, without this closure. I'm gonna use this one. So here we're gonna stop, and I'm gonna glue this. I'm gonna show you how. This is cover for my journal where I would like to use it. And I'm gonna glue this without this top part here inside of my front cover. It will be glued here, and it will be like decoration here. If you would like to use in your journals, you would like to use in your journals also this magnetic part, you need to create in your spine, that inside spine of your journal where you're gonna sew your inserts, your signatures. Here is what I'm gonna put in that cover. So if you would like to use it also with this magnetic part, you will need to create right next to your signatures that Hinge. I think it's called Hinge. It's just scoring clients, three scoring clients, half an inch, and you're gonna fold it. So here you will have a hinge like this. Here will be hinge like this. I'm gonna fold it just with my fingers because this will be glued under my envelope, so it will be lost under that envelope. I'm just gonna show you what I mean. Here you need to create with scoring board or scoring tool some hinge. It will look like this. It's just fast, okay? Do not judge me for this one. And on this hinge, which will be right next to your signatures. Oh, I lost it. Where is it? Oh, it's here. No, it's not. It's here. Oh my. You will need to glue down from one side and then glue on the top all those papers here. But because I'm not gonna use it here on that hinge, I can decorate that part, just not glue it down. Oh, no, I'm not gonna glue it down. So here, I'm just gonna show you what I made. This tutorial will be a little bit crazy. I glued down this paper, then I glued down my envelope like this. And then I took my magnets. I used double-sided tape. And I put my magnets on my envelope, on this small envelope, on two parts, like here and here. I put my magnets. I don't have that repositional tape. If I will have it, I will probably glue it just to show you how you can create it. Because it's moving, I'm gonna put here a small piece of the double-sided tape. So it will hold for a small time. Hey, come on. I'm sorry. Maybe use this, right? Yes. So, just for this part. Then I took that top of my cover and I very lightly pressed that. I found with my fingers where are my magnets and I pressed that. You can see very teeny, mini, small small holes here. I placed there on those pieces where I saw teeny meeny shadows. Where was that magnet? I placed double-sided tape. I put second magnet here. Oops. And then I pressed again the top envelope on these magnets. As you can see, we have them here. And then I just decorate it with paper here, like this. And I decorate that with paper on that opposite side. And I put decorative paper inside as well, inside of this envelope. That was what I create, how I create this this magnetic closure. I put decorative paper inside of my envelope. I'm just gonna slide it in, just on this purpose. I put decorative paper here. and then you've got your magnetic closure. That was how I create this one. And how long it is? Oh, it's already 1 hour again. I thought that this tutorial will be much more easy, much more shorter than that previous one, and it's much more confusing than I thought. I'm just gonna shortly show you. I've got here my signatures. I'm using, as you can see, I'm using those boxes from pet food, because they are very strong. I've got double layers. I've got one layer here, another layer here, also top cover. It's from two layers, which makes that cover very strong. And now what I create, I sewn my signatures in a piece of cardstock, and because that cardstock, it's not strong enough, I'm using from that bottom part here. This is tape, which is using, I think, in buildings for making something stronger, but I don't remember name of that tape. But it's this grit tape. It's very strong. It's like plastic, and it's sticky. It's adhesive, and it's very flexible. It's really very flexible. So I'm using it on the bottom part of my paper. It's make it stronger, and my papers will be not ripped off from this paper. What I'm gonna do now, I'm just gonna put double-sided tape on these edges. I can do it now, I think. And it will make also that flexible edge. I need some smaller, I think. I'm gonna put double-sided tape on my paper, and because I don't have smaller double-sided tape, I need to use this one, and I need to fold it a little bit, probably. And I'm gonna place double-sided tape on this edge as well. Not on all part, not I'm not gonna use double-sided tape here where I've got my signature sewn. I'm gonna take off. My double-sided tape. Gonna fold these edges a little bit. And now I need to put my signatures inside of my journal. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put signatures right in middle on my spine to make sure I'm holding, I need to move this one to be on in the view. I'm holding those excess of my paper in my signatures, and I'm gonna place my signatures right in middle to make sure that it's on the same size, on same direction, straight in middle, and that it's from the top and from the bottom on a similar size. I think I'm right, and I'm gonna glue it down here. Like this, and then I'm gonna glue it down here to make sure that my papers will be nice and even. And now here I can glue down the part we created last time, but I decorated it a little bit with laces and with die cuts. So I can glue it down here. I just need to use some good glue, because here I've got already double-sided tape. I'm gonna use this time this one, Uhu glue, because it's much more stronger, and it's dry better, I think. It's hold better. So I'm gonna put just on edges this Uhu glue. And I'm gonna make some nice position of my layout. It will be here, and a similar way I will do it here, but I just need to decorate all these pockets with laces and with embellishments I want, and it's much more easy to do it when it's flat like this. So then you will have your decorative part in your journals like this. So here we will have many pockets and inserts and tags and all that stuff, and similar it will be here on the front cover, and all those signatures will be between. So this is my sharing for today. I hope it wasn't confusing. I hope I gave you some idea. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for all your amazing comments. I will try to do that next file folder for Slavka as soon as possible. And I got few other tutorials already uploaded. They will be tomorrow and day after. So I hope you will enjoy it as well. Thank you so much for watching. Sorry that it's too long, and have a beautiful day, and see you next time. Bye.